The continuation of preparation of ethers. If same molecule contain halogen and alcohol, halogen and alcohol, here is OH.
Sir, we are writing for the long run, sir.
Inka long run, ela?
Yeah, long
run. Okay.
Continue.
Right. If same molecule contains hydroxy group and bromine, this is known as Williamson synthesis. Williamson synthesis. So loss of Br- takes place. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So five-membered ring with oxygen, then contains here lone pair of electrons, here positive charge, 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth carbon. Now loss of H plus takes place here, loss of H plus takes place here to form a cyclic ether. Which ether? Cyclic ether. So this particular reaction is known as Williamson synthesis. It is a intramolecular Williamson synthesis. Intramolecular Williamson synthesis. Hydroxy group as well as bromine in same molecule. It is also involved in intramolecular Williamson synthesis to form a cyclic ether. This is what? 6-membered. This is what? 5-membered. Cyclic ether. Which ether? Cyclic ether. So this is about the synthesis, Williamson synthesis. Then second one is from alcohols. Second synthesis of ethers is from alcohols. Right. When alcohols, 2 moles of alcohol in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid at 140 degrees centigrade, at 140 degrees centigrade, it forms an ether. Now, when we go for the mechanism of this particular reaction, sulfuric acid dissociates into H plus and HSO4 minus. Now first mole of alcohol is protonated with H plus ion. Here is what? H plus ion. Now it is converts into R. Here is carries H plus, then loss of water molecule takes place here, then to form a carbocation. This carbocation again reacts with another mole of an alcohol, then R oxygen, R carries positive charge, again loss of H plus takes place. It is converts into ROR. Okay, so this is the mechanism of this one. For example, CH3, NaCH2, 2 moles of ethyl alcohol in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, 140 degrees centigrade to form diethyl ether.
morning. If you are taking benzyl alcohol plus methyl alcohol in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, the major product is which one? NSO. NSO. Okay, this is the first method from alcohol. Then the second method is an alcohol. Second method is an alcohol reacts with diazomethane in presence of DMSO, dimethyl sulfoxide, as a non-polar solvent. Now it forms RCH3. What is this? RCH3. Now, can you see the mechanism of this one? This is what CH2 minus M triple bond N, here carries which are positive charge. This negative charge attack on this, loss of this one takes place, it forms alkoxide ion. This alkoxide ion CH3, here is N2 plus. Attach on this, loss of which molecule takes place, N2 molecule, to form RCH3. For example, phenol, when phenol reacts with diazomethane, this is known as diazomethane. Phenol reacts with diazomethane, for by heating, it forms an aromatic ether known as NSO. This is known as what? NSO, the aromatic ether. This is the second method from alcohol. Then, alcohols also react with dimethyl sulfate in presence of a basic medium, that is sodium hydroxide. So generally it can act as a good methylating agent. So therefore RO is for CH3. For example, if you are taking ethyl alcohol, DMS, dimethyl sulfate, this is DMS, dimethyl sulfate in presence of basic medium to form CH2, N is O, then it is what? CH3. The same way, phenol reacts with dimethyl sulfate in presence of basic medium to form phenyl methyl ether. Result, methyl phenyl ether, commonly known as what? NSO. Next, third method of the preparation of ethers, that is alkoxymercuration and demercuration. alkoxy, methuration, alkoxy methuration and demethuration, alkoxy methuration and demethuration of alkene. Now reagent is silver estate, that is, then in presence of an alcohol. Second one is, this is the first reagent. Second reagent is sodium borohydride in presence of which medium? Basic medium. Now C double bond C is an alkene, react with an alkene, react with mercuric estate O CO CH3 two times. Now it forms a complex initially, mercury, then it is like this, then oxygen C double bond O, here is for CH3. Now for this an alcohol is added, ROHH, there is lone pair of electrons, it will attack on this particular direction. Now it converts into HGOAC, then RO, here is hydrogen, loss of H plus takes place here, loss of H plus. Now it converts into HG OAC, then here is what OR. This particular steps are known as alkoxy methylation. This particular steps are known as what? Alkoxy methylation. Then demethylation, we can use which one? Sodium borohydride. What is that? Sodium borohydride. So generally it can act as a H minus donor. Which donor? H minus donor. So therefore it converts into ether. This is the mechanism of which one? Alkoxy methylation and demethylation of which one? Alkene. For example, CH3, CH double bond, here is what? CH2, reactivate mercuric estate in presence of methyl alcohol. This is the first step. The second step is sodium borohydride in presence of basic medium. Basic medium, it forms direct Markovnik of rule OCH3, then it is what? CH3. Okay, the name of this compound is 2-methoxypropane. What is this? 2-methoxypropane. So this is about, these are the complete preparative methods of which one? Ethers. So one is from alkyl halides, that is Williamson synthesis. Second one is from alcohol. Third one is which one? From alkenes. Alkenes, commonly the method is which one? Alkoxy methylation and demethylation. So these are the preparatory methods of which one? Ethers. Now coming to the physical properties. Physical properties of ethers. Physical properties of ether. Okay. Okay, now there are preparations. Now, clear? Now, you also have to do it. physical properties of ethers. Now, the first one is alcohols and ethers are functional isomers. Okay, solubility. Second one, solubility. Generally, alcohols are easily soluble in water when compared to ether. The reason is intermolecular hydrogen bond. Okay, solubility in water, alcohols, ROH is greater than that of ether. The reason is due to hydrogen bonds. Which bonds? Hydrogen bonds. So due to formation of hydrogen bonds, association increases. So that is the reason why alcohols are mainly soluble. Lower number of alcohols are mainly soluble in water when compared to which one? Ethers. Next, third one is ethers are mainly soluble in non-polar solvents. Example, NHZ. Okay, na? Chloroform, etc. Then coming to the boiling points of ethers and alcohols. Okay. Boiling points of ethers and alcohols. Alcohols are having high boiling points when compared to which one? Ethers. The reason is intermolecular hydrogen bond. Which one? Intermolecular hydrogen bond. For example, alkane or butane. Example, butane and butane. Second one is butanol. Third one is butanol. The last one is N-propyl methyl ether. Okay, when we compare the boiling points of this one, here we have, this is the first one, this is second one, third one, this is which one? Fourth one. Which one it is? Fourth one. Okay, if you compare the boiling points of these three, butanol is order of boiling points is second one greater than third one greater than fourth one greater than which one? First one. The reason is alcohols are shows intermolecular hydrogen bond. Aldehydes are shows dipole attractive force, but ethers are shows only dipole forces. Now ethers are shows for dipole forces. It has what? Dipole attractive force is very more than compared to which one? Ether. So that is the reason why alcohols are shows high boiling points compared to aldehydes as well as for ethers. So here is only weak van der Waals attractive forces. Which forces? Weak van der Waals attractive forces. So that is the reason why butane has less boiling points when compared to alcohol. So finally, what I am saying here, alcohols are shows high boiling points when compared to ether and aldehydes, having almost equal. equal molecular weight, having almost equal molecular weight. So this is about which one? Physical properties of ethers. Then next one is chemical properties.